Tell me you're a virtual teacher without telling me. I put this image on my Instagram account this last week. I've had some hilarious comments on the post. So I thought I would make a little tell me you're a virtual teacher without telling me you're a virtual teacher video and go through some of the comments that really stood out to me. I didn't choose all of them. They were all unique and special, but the ones that really stood out to me, maybe things that I've experienced or things that I just thought were hilarious, I want to share with you. So I'm going to put the comments down here in a little box, so that you can see who commented, giving credit where credit is due, and comment down below in the comments which one is your favorite. Let's go ahead and see which one gets the most votes. I think this is really gonna be hilarious. I think that's it. Let's go ahead and jump in to the video. LPJ Kid says, good morning class. Whether you're with me live or watching me on demand, we have such a fun morning of learning in store. So this sounds like this teacher is a hybrid teacher, which has its own challenges in itself. Teacher to the core, Katie Knight. She said, when I'm on camera, I look lit on top and like I'm sleeping on the bottom. That is true. We're like a nice business casual top with like some comfy leggings or, you know, pajamas. I've been there. The Adventures of MSBS Busy BS. She says, I own 3 ring lights. Yes, you would be a virtual teacher if you owned 3 ring lights. Alauraman, A-L-A-U-E-R-M-A-N says, I'm gonna share my screen. Can you all see my screen now? That's like a constant. Miss Spice and Everything Nice, I like your name. She says, I haven't worn real pants in 11 months. Yep, that pretty much sums it up. Lauren Borkowski says, no, Simba, your cat, can't do your homework for you just because he showed up on Zoom today. Chad Aquamecki, they say, looking at the blank stares on my kids' faces because my mic was muted the entire time. Yep, been there. And they don't say anything. The kids don't say anything sometimes. Allurman says, I'm a virtual teacher because I talk to gray squares all day. I've heard that some districts do not allow you to tell the kids that you have to have, like that they have to have their cameras on. Are you in that kind of school district? If you are, comment down below or give this video a like. Dawn IEI says, honey, thanks for showing us your baby brother. Now please put him down so we can finish math. Kirby's Classroom. Aaron, if you're talking, you're muted. Aaron, are you there? All right, Joss Barrios 4 says, I have said this many a times. Please stay muted while I'm giving directions. That is totally one. One of my biggest pet peeves is when they unmute themselves without asking and then they just start talking over you and like you can't figure out which kid it is because there's so many little squares. Darcy Anders says, no, I don't want to see your cat, dog, birds, lizard, or snake. This is why we do show and tell, because sometimes the kids are so excited about, like, I know in the beginning too, like, the kids are so excited about giving you a glimpse into their world. So there's times where we'll do like a scavenger hunt or a show and tell activity where they can choose what item. So I know that's a real thing, but it is kind of annoying when they do it constantly. Blur714, please no eating while on Zoom. Spitting your sunflower seed shells out is not allowed. Your seeds are hitting the camera. I'm sorry, you'll have to go to the waiting room for a bit. The wonderful happened. You're frozen. Can you still hear me? I feel like that right there, I have internet connection or I can't hear you or you're muted. I say that at least 10 times per call. H-L-O-R-N. Mrs. H, I just got kicked out. What are we doing? Oh man, the struggle is real. It's hard too because when kids come back in from Zoom, all of the comments in the chats, like if you send a link or any of the comments disappear. So you have to kind of like re-paste everything, which can totally be annoying. This one is hilarious. Shannon Delabar says, please make sure your family knows that we can all see them. I had one student come to class in their undies. True story, really happened. Aragon Life, a student brought their chicken to Zoom today. I had that happen once and it was like clawing the poor kid's face. I'm like, go put it back outside. Mikayy7 says, students asking, do we have to attach our work in math class or where's your dog? Mary Sanson says, Can you turn off the TV, please? Oh man, I've had that happen. Or the video games, that's the worst. The worst or the funniest is when you have a student who's playing video games and then unmutes himself or herself without realizing it, and then they shout out something that's like video game related and the entire class hears it. You're like, I caught you. You're not focused. All right, next one. Melody J. Noss says, student points laser directly into the camera. Please don't do that. Another one from Mary Sanson. She says, I saw one of my students in person for the first time and he had no idea who I was. Oh, that's so hard. There is that like disconnect when you're virtually teaching. Oh, that is so difficult. Next one, the hodgepodge teacher. Hey kiddo, you're muted. No, I still can't hear you. Unmute. Or this one's so funny. Wow, only 200 seesaw assignments to approve. All right, Mrs. Mobster. If you can hear my voice, come back to the classroom for writing. Break is over. It's like when you're looking at all of your Zoom squares and you see their living room or their room, but they're not on camera. It's the whole, if you can hear my voice, come back to the screen. That's funny. Oh my goodness, this one's hilarious. Kay Smolsky says, Mr. Poopoo Pants. That's an interesting name. Like my rule in class is your name has to actually be your real name unless we're doing like a special activity. So we did a reader's theater a week ago and my students were able to change their names to the character name that they were assigned in the reader's theater. But in the beginning when we didn't have rules established, this was definitely one that I felt like I had to constantly be reminding them this and their background. Like, sorry, but you can't have an inappropriate background on your Zoom background. So we're gonna go with no background. That means turn the background off right now. Thank you. ABCs with Mrs. Anthony says, parent, can you please turn off the TV or tablet so they can focus and read the words on the screen? Oh, that is frustrating. That's so frustrating. When you have parents who work from home, I have that situation where the student's trying to focus and when they unmute themselves, you can hear all the noise and stuff in the background. Oof, that's really tough. Struggles. Gretchen Lech says, please complete the assignment before turning it in on Google Classroom. Oh, that's frustrating. Oh my goodness, they turned it in and it's not done, but it's like marked complete. Teach WMS Marvin, I'm assuming that's Teach with Miss Marvin. Please don't put your feet in front of the camera. C-R-H-U-I. I'm gonna have to turn off the annotate option if you don't stop scribbling on the screen now. I didn't even know that was an option. I guess it is. I guess in Zoom you can share your screen and if they have like the annotation feature, that's pretty cool. That's funny. My cheeky little classroom. Stop putting your headphone mic in your mouth, please. It's gonna break again. Mary Lou, yes, I see your cute stuffed animal. Now please take it away from the camera and get back to work. And you're muted. Yeah, unmute yourself and then you can answer me. Sometimes it's hard to like keep a straight face these times too. You almost have to get silly to like not cry. Jen Aya LVISJ says, please don't lick the camera. No, no, don't do it again. Oh, there's jelly on it. Oh, why don't you get a napkin or wipe or go get your mom? All right, some of those were hilarious. If you had a favorite that stood out to you, go ahead and comment down below in the comment section. I'm gonna put my favorite one here. This one was hilarious. As always, if you aren't a part of the Kinderhearted family, consider hitting that bell and subscribe button. Join the family, we'd love to have you. I try to post content that's relevant, funny, helpful, up to date on best practices, all the things, and hopefully content that just adds value to your life. So that's all I've got for you today. Hopefully you enjoyed this kind of video. If you did, please comment down below, give me some feedback. I will see you in the next video. Bye.